recent days, the U.S. has dramatically tightened security on the border with Mexico, in particular around the San Diego-Tijuana area, including a pre-dawn closure of the country's busiest crossing at San Ysidro on Monday. It reopened after several hours, but almost half the vehicle lanes remained closed. In recent weeks, U.S. military troops rolled out more than 12 miles of barbed wire along the border. And over the weekend, work crews reinforced another part of the border fence by covering it completely in coiled razor wire, which brought this tweet from the U.S. president. The fake news is showing old footage of people climbing over our ocean area fence. This is what it really looks like. No climbers anymore under our administration. All of these measures are intended to harden the border because Customs and Border Protection believes some of the thousands of immigrants who recently arrived in Mexico may try to force their way into the U.S. Here's part of a statement they issued on Monday. In the early morning hours, CBP officials received reports of groups of persons from the caravan gathering in the city of Tijuana for a possible attempt, all attempts, to rush illegally through the port of entry instead of presenting themselves as required to a CBP officer. At least one activist group says that claim is a deliberate attempt to mislead the public and demonize refugees. Many have questioned this administration's claims of just how big the threat really is from thousands of poor, desperate immigrants in those caravans, many seeking asylum from violence and political persecution, which followed widespread outrage over the administration's policy of separating parents from their children. And then there's the signature campaign promise made by candidate Trump to build a wall on the border, what critics have called a solution in search of a problem. Now, all of those concerns, all those criticisms have been put to music, a reggae rap from the band Big Mountain. It's a long way from their 1994 hit, which may be a little more familiar. Joining us now from Los Angeles is lead singer Keena McWinnie, and in Chicago, Dr. John Marquez, who sings on the song, is also a professor of Latin studies at Northwestern University. Guys, thanks for coming in. Good to see you both.
So nice to be here.
Okay, Keena, let's start with you.
Thanks for having us.
It is a big leap from Baby, I Love Your Way to Deportation Nation. But when you look at your background and the history of the band, it becomes pretty clear the issues on the border are pretty personal.
Yeah, we've always been artists, activists, you know, from the very beginning. Big Mountain was actually inspired to take on the name Big Mountain because of a group of Native Americans, Navajo, Diné people that were being forced to relocate from their native lands. And that was our first few shows we're doing benefits for those folks. So we've always been conscious. That's what we believe reggae music is all about. Staying provocative and just giving the people the truth the best way we can with music.
There have been a lot of controversies surrounding President Trump, you know, and immigration. You know, it started from the moment he started his campaign, and they've just kept coming. But was there one incident in particular which you felt was the moment when you needed to make this song?
Well, our second album, actually the album that had Baby, I Love Your Way on it, also had a song called Border Town. And it centered around the activities that were going on back then, 1994. If you remember, that was the year that NAFTA was inducted. A big militarization of the border called Operation Gatekeeper was taking place. So we've just been very tied into the activist border community. I'm appalled every day at some of the things that President Trump is using, some of the political ploys that he uses to get his base rallied up at the expense of human beings, people that are really suffering, people that really need help. And, you know, the reason we did this song is to show solidarity with them.
Okay, so here's part of the song which specifically deals with the U.S. President Donald Trump.
My reality shaking. Now everyone's talking, and history is watching.
know, you mentioned this, Kino, the issue of mass deportation did not start under this administration. At one point, President Obama was deporting 400,000 undocumented immigrants a year. That was the result of a policy which began under President Bill Clinton.
All Americans, not only in the states most heavily affected, but in every place in this country, are rightly disturbed by the large numbers of illegal aliens entering our country. The jobs they hold might otherwise be held by citizens or legal immigrants. The public service they use impose burdens on our taxpayers. That's why our administration has moved aggressively to secure our borders more by hiring a record number of new border guards.
So, John, to you, why was it not the same anger, you know, the same protest when past presidents have implemented a crackdown on immigration?
I don't think that's entirely accurate. I think we've been raising awareness around border militarization and the plight of immigrants now, at least Kino and I have, for over 20 years. I think the most powerful element of the more recent art that we've produced with Deportation Nation is a critique more of American history than it is of one particular president. We've just found it a unique opportunity to raise that awareness once again. Unfortunately, we're having to do it time and time again, but there's a strong anti-Brown undercurrent to American nationalism that contradicts the heroic contributions that Mexicano and Centro Americano people have made towards the building and maintaining of this nation state. As artists, we feel that our work is to pull back the curtain on the illusion that Kino mentioned earlier, through which immigrants, specifically Mexicanos or Centro Americanos, those along the borderlands are persecuted as an invasive species or as a parasite to the nation state, despite how much we contribute, despite the sacrifices our families have made over time. My grandfather and namesake crossed the border without proper documentation when he received a draft call to join the U.S. Army, and he joined a caravan of soldiers that stormed beaches in France to rid or free Western Europe from fascist impulse or a growing fascist threat. That's the type of American story that we're trying to tell alongside our critique of the persecution of immigrants that's ongoing now. It is a land that needs to cry, needs a mind to hold, so much inside, the centuries of sorrow, centuries of sorrow.
Here's another part of the song, and it focuses on child separation at the border. And it's done to rap by John. So listen to this.
Lock our children in cages and they will reinvent our world. Redefine what it means to be a nation. You know not what you do. The steel is making us stronger. Our radical traditions are rooted in how we live and love otherwise.
Lock our children in cages and they will reinvent our world. Redefine what it means to be a nation. So, John, what you're saying is that that policy, that specific policy implemented by Donald Trump and Jeff Sessions, the Attorney General, somehow it changed what it meant to be American?
No, that's not necessarily what I mean. I meant by that. What I meant, I was referring to what I describe as a Brown radical tradition. There's always been caravans of people migrating to improve their lives. There's always been caravans of people displaced and dispossessed of opportunities. What I'm referring to is the way that our communities stick together, mostly through the work of women, mostly through the work of Mexicanas or Latinas, who hold our families and hold our communities together, despite the persecution that we suffer, despite the threat of deportation, despite mass incarceration. What I'm trying to convey in that piece of art is a message both to our people, to our communities, to our barrios, that we will persevere through this. And out of this discrimination, out of these forms of criminalization, we grow stronger. And it is through the struggle that we grow stronger. It is through the struggle that we'll build a better community and continue to serve and set an example for what a true democracy is, which is built upon the sacrifices of hardworking people, such as our ancestors and such as those who have held down the communities that we come from.
This is a U.S. president who made a deliberate choice ahead of the midterm elections to stoke fear of immigrants, and in a way it was a strategy which kind of worked. It helped Republicans increase their majority in the Senate, which means that there are a lot of Americans out there who are willing to cast their votes to support a man who makes blatantly racist remarks.
The United States, man. It's a shame to think that in this time and age, we still have to deal, like John said. The battle continues. I wish that news organizations would spend a little bit more time elaborating on Central American history, for instance. The United Fruit Company has been in Central America for over 100 years. You know how many bananas that is? The people of Central America have contributed greatly to this country. And the way that Donald Trump is able to manipulate the news and just stoke the fear of his supporters, it's really a shame. But that's why we artists, that's why we, make the art that we make. If we want a better world, first it has to be imagined. And that's what the responsibility of singers, painters, poets. We're the ones that imagine a better world. And then we hand it off to the people that are supposed to do the hard work, you know? But it's... I have my spot, but then my spot was taken. My reality shaken. Everyone's
talking. John and Kino, thank you so much. It was great to speak with you guys. Appreciate it.
Thank you.